No? No? You know, this is a big topic. You know, if I start this, it will go on forever.
Yeah. See, I have a question. It's mentioned as three-way matching, right? But we are only matching to two, right? Your quantity and price.
So there's three-way matching. Maybe three documents are matched. You have purchase order, you have GR and IR.
Okay.
This is called three-way matching. Okay. So your purchase, well, I get to what you're saying. There is, the matching is only two. Why is this called three-way matching, right? The three-way matching as the process matches the supplier invoice received with the good receipts in terms of quantity. And then it matches the invoice. Okay, so actually quantity, actually, you know, you may be right. Let's rephrase this. Invoice is matched. Invoice is matched with the GR, okay? And invoice is matched with the PO. Okay, there's still two-way matching. So the invoice, when you receive an invoice, it wants to make sure, let's say, that's what I'm saying, right? You have a purchase order of 100. Okay, but the good receipt, the warehouse received only 80. Okay, now the invoice is coming in. The invoice they are sending in is for 80 also, okay? So in this situation, the quantity, the IR is matched with the GR. Okay? So it only looks at the quantity. It doesn't, you know, the whole GRIR process looks at the quantity, okay? If there's a price difference, it treats differently. For now, logistics invoice verification, I'm going to skip the topic. Just so you know, this is called three-way matching, okay? Why they have three-way matching is sometimes you have the quantity that you order, purchase order might be different from what you receive, right? And then let's say you receive an invoice, which is again more than what they delivered, the invoice will be blocked, okay? There's something called quantity surplus. Invoice surplus and delivery surplus. Okay, so the concept you have to learn is quantity surplus and invoice surplus. Okay,